Picture this. You're driving down the road and a deer, or worse yet, a child, runs out in front of you. What do you do? Well, instinctively, you hit the brakes. At that moment, all you want to do is stop your vehicle, and you expect your brakes to work. You expect the original equipment manufacturer to have designed and built a system that will stop your vehicle quickly and safely. You expect vendors who have retrofitted your wheelchair-accessible van to either leave that OEM system completely intact, or at the very least, do not have compromised its performance. Well, like it or not, expectations have absolutely nothing to do with actual performance. Only knowing will assure that your brakes, in this case, will work as they were designed to. And knowing means you have to ask the right questions and challenge assumptions. Don't worry, I'm not asking you to crawl under your van and inspect what every manufacturer does as part of their lowered floor conversion. I've already done that. Let's have a look at what I found. As you can imagine, the company that built your original vehicle invested a huge amount of time, energy, and money in designing and building their brake systems to run from point A to point B along a specific path under the vehicle. So, it makes sense that any attempt by any manufacturer to lower the floor of your vehicle would require a disruption of that path. You can't simply drop a floor a number of inches and expect that same OEM equipment to fit. So ask yourself, how does the manufacturer I'm considering restore the brake lines? Well, unfortunately, while you assume that safety is the dominant factor when it comes to your new lowered floor vehicle, that may not exactly be the case. In some cases, cost plays a significant role, and perhaps more of a role than it should. While all manufacturers are required to self-test and pass certification, an actual look at the ways in which they do that might raise a few questions. Let's take a look at two manufacturers of wheelchair-accessible vehicles. And if you look closely, you can see that both of these manufacturers took the existing lines, straightened, pulled, and maneuvered them out of their original configuration and rebent them to the new contour of their particular vans. While reusing what you have to save money might make sense in some cases, remember, we're talking about brake lines here. There's not a lot of margin for error. Also, as you can see here, these original lines have been reattached in a way that puts them into direct contact with the frame of the vehicle, using what's called a P-clip. That creates a couple of problems. First, you have brake lines that are not only rubbing against the frame in a way that could easily cause wear just because of the simple motion of the vehicle, but as you can see, you also have lines that are coming into contact with each other, which creates the potential for more wear and tear. Now, even though this manufacturer uses foam buffers of some sort to separate the lines in an apparent attempt to keep them from rubbing, the material itself is a problem because it absorbs water and can easily collect dirt and grit, which, as you know, can add to the likelihood of corrosion and potential failure. I also want you to notice that rerouting of the brake lines on these two vehicles resulted in a lot of extra line. And these two manufacturers chose to handle that excess in slightly different, but equally problematic ways. In this case, the excess line was coiled and just suspended in this recess. And in the other, it was wound back and forth in kind of a zigzag pattern. True, they didn't have to cut and subsequently reconnect the line, which would have taken time and money. But you also have all this extra just hanging here, where it can get snagged and kinked, not to mention all of the extra brake fluid in there. Why? So, what choice do you have? Well, when it comes to a system that you're relying on, don't you think it makes sense to go straight to the original equipment manufacturer to be sure that the brake lines and fittings meet OEM specifications and are designed and built for the wheelchair-accessible vehicle you want to buy? BraunAbility does exactly that. As you can see, all of these brake lines are new. They follow OEM specifications and use the connectors that have been tested and retested by the OEM. They were also designed by engineers in advance to follow a defined path from point A to point B, and that means no bending or rebending was needed, and no excess line. And in areas where there's even a potential for contact with the frame or other parts of the vehicle, BraunAbility strategically builds in spiral spring covers to protect those brake lines. When it comes to connecting those lines to the vehicle, BraunAbility uses what's called a Christmas tree clip that not only isolates the brake lines from the vehicle frame to prevent wear, but also isolates them from each other. The clips plug into holes that are lasered into the frame and then primed and undercoated to make the metal around the hole more resistant to corrosion. And while it's not a safety concern, BraunAbility's design lends to labor cost savings when it comes to repair, because this design allows technicians to remove and replace lines more easily than either of the two manufacturers you've seen here. Now, unless you have money to burn, cost has to be a consideration in any purchase, in any investment. Now, I promised I'd give it to you straight, but which brake system would you want to rely on? Can you afford to have cost be the dominating factor when it comes to the reliability of that system? Should you? If you ask me, that answer is no. The choice is yours.